Now, in the first part of microwave tunnel diode, we have seen the construction of tunnel diode, the necessary conditions required for tunneling, and the basic working principle of tunnel diode, the IV characteristics of tunnel diode, etc. Now, in this section, we are going to see about the tunnel diode characteristics. That is, the tunnel diode, it can be used as a microwave oscillator and an amplifier in its negative resistance portion. So here we will see some of the characteristics, that is IV characteristics of tunnel diode, say with the load line, and the equivalent circuit of tunnel diode when it exhibits its negative resistance region, and how a tunnel diode can be used with a resistive load as an amplifier, and also about how a tunnel diode can be worked as an amplifier when used along with the microwave circulator, and also we will see about a tunnel diode oscillator when connected along with the tank circuit. So these are some of the portions we will see in this particular lecture. Now coming to the tunnel diode characteristics. So we have seen about the construction of tunnel diode, conditions of the tunneling to take place in tunnel diode, the basic working principle of tunnel diode. Now, the tunnel diode, you have to understand that they are used as microwave oscillators and amplifiers because of the diode exhibiting a negative resistance characteristic in the region between peak current IP and valley current IV. That is, as we have already seen in the IV diagram, between the values of the peak current IP and the valley current of IV, the diode is going to exhibit a negative resistance property. So in this negative resistance property only, the tunnel diode finds applications as microwave oscillators and microwave amplifiers. Now we will see some of the characteristics of tunnel diode. So this figure shows the IV characteristics of tunnel diode. So the nature of IV characteristics we already know. Now, from the IV characteristics, we could draw some inferences. Okay, so we consider here three load lines. So, the three load lines shown here are, first load line is say ABC, it is touching three points. Okay, in the IV diagram. So, this is the first load line, say ABC. And then you can see the second load line which touches only the point B. And then another load line which touches only the point A. So based upon these three load lines, we could draw some inferences of the characteristics of the tunnel. Now, when we can observe the first load line in the IV cara of tunnel diode, say the load line of ABC. So in this condition, the tunnel diode works as a bistable circuit. Here the ABC load line intersects the characteristic curve in three points. So you can see here that the A and C, they are what? The stable points, but B is a unstable point. That is, B is occurring in the negative resistance region of the tunnel diode. So B is an unstable point and it can vary in the either way, but A and C here are the stable points. So if the voltage and the current vary about B, the final values of the current and voltage would be given by either by a point of A or C, but not B. So in this load line condition, we are having two stable states, that is A and C. So the circuit can be called as a bistable circuit. Okay, so it can be utilized as a binary device in switching circuit. So from the IV characteristics of tunnel diode, we are considering three load lines and drawing the inferences on how the tunnel diodes can be used. So at this particular load line condition, that is at the ABC point, we are having two stable points. So we are stating that it could be used as a bistable circuit. Okay, so now we'll proceed to the next load line. So when we are considering the next load line here, say the IV curve intersecting only at point B. So at this point, we know the tunnel diode is in the negative resistance region. So this is the region where it enables a tunnel diode to work as a microwave amplifier or a microwave oscillator. And it is a negative resistance region. So it is called as an unstable point, say point of B. So at this case, or for this load line, we can say that the tunnel diode is functioning as a stable circuit. And when we are considering the third load line that is intersecting say only at a point of A. Point A is a stable point, there is only a single stable point. So at this way you can say the tunnel diode is a monostable circuit. So another load line crossing the point A is in the positive resistance region. So at this point the tunnel diode is a monostable. So using the IV characteristics of the tunnel diode, we have seen that we have used the three load lines and stated some three characteristics of tunnel diode. But always it is important that to understand that in the negative resistance region only the tunnel diode is going to work mainly as a microwave amplifier and a microwave oscillator. Now from the IV characteristics we are going to consider mainly about the negative resistance region, because we know it is a region where we can suitably use our tunnel diode as a microwave amplifier or oscillator. So when we are considering the negative conductance, which is indicated by minus G, you can write it as dou I by dou V at the point of VB. Why VB? Because we are considering the voltage say at the point B, that is considering this particular load line, and considering the point P, so the voltage is VB. So you can represent it as 1 by minus of Rn, because we know conductance is a given by 1 by the resistance value. So Rn here is representing what? That is the magnitude of the negative resistance of the tunnel diode. So remember, capital Rn represents the magnitude of negative resistance of the tunnel diode. Now when we are drawing a small signal equivalent circuit for the tunnel diode operated in the negative resistance region, it can be represented as such. Okay, so here Zn is the input impedance, Rs and the Ls, they are the resistance and the inductance of the packaging circuit of the tunnel diode. So we have considered this equivalent circuit in the negative resistance region, and here C represents the junction capacitance of the tunnel diode at the valley point, that is till the negative resistance part. So at the valley point, what will be the junction capacitance of the tunnel diode? And Rn, as I already told, is a magnitude of the negative resistance of the tunnel diode. So this much part only we are considering. Okay, so and we have drawn the equivalent circuit, and now we will write the input impedance for the equivalent circuit. So how do you write the input impedance? Here we know Rs and Ls, they are in series. So Rs plus j omega Ls, and here Rn and 1 by j omega C we consider in parallel. So we write the expression, and then what we do is that we are separating the imaginary part and the real part and writing the equation. So here we have considered only the negative characteristic of tunnel diode, its equivalent circuit, and then we are writing the equation for the input impedance. Now from the equation of the input impedance, what we have to understand is that we could draw the inferences about two types of frequency for our tunnel diode, that is a self-resonating frequency and the resistive cutoff frequency. So since we have considered our tunnel diode to be working only in the negative resistance region, we have considered the equivalent circuit of that particular region. The tunnel diode can be obviously used as a say a oscillator or as an amplifier. So how do you find out the self-resonating frequency for the tunnel diode? In the input impedance equation, we have to consider the imaginary part of the equation to be equal to 0. So when you equate the imaginary part of the input impedance to be equal to 0, we get the expression for self-resonating frequency of the tunnel diode as such. And also to find out the resistive cutoff frequency, we have to consider the real part of input impedance to be equal to 0. So when you consider the real part of input impedance to be equal to 0, we get the resistive cutoff frequency FR to be as such. So that is why we have separated in the equation the imaginary term and the real part. So the tunnel diode again can be connected either in series or in parallel with the resistive load as an amplifier in its equivalent circuits. Okay, so we will proceed to how a tunnel diode can be connected in parallel with the resistive load as an amplifier. Now here we consider the tunnel diode to be connected in parallel with the load resistor as an amplifier. So this is actually we have connected in parallel to a load resistor with a tunnel diode. So we can write here, say the expression for the output power. What will be the output power which is coming in the load resistance of RL? It will be V squared by RL. Now we know that some part of the output power will be contributed by the input power which is coming from the tunnel diode. It can be due to the negative resistance property of the tunnel diode, and it can also be due to the gain of the tunnel diode. That is, other than the negative resistance characteristic, there will be some gain associated with the tunnel diode amplifier. So both of these input power is only contributing to the output power in the load resistance. So first of all, we have written the expression for the output power in the load resistance as V squared by RL. Then we are saying that one part of this output power is generated by the small input power through the tunnel diode amplifier with a gain of A. So the input power is equal to V square by ARL, where A represents the gain of the tunnel diode amplifier, and another power is generated by the negative resistance of the tunnel diode. We know the magnitude for the negative resistance of tunnel diode, we have represented it as RN. So P in here will be V square divided by RN. So these two input powers from the tunnel diode, that is one due to the negative resistance of tunnel diode and other due to the gain of the tunnel diode amplifier, is only contributing to the output power. So adding these two input power, we get the output power. So equating this, we get the expression for the gain of the tunnel diode amplifier A as RN divided by RN minus RL. So from this equation, we can say that when the negative resistance, say RN of the tunnel diode, is approaching the load resistance of RL, that is, it is becoming equal, the denominator term becomes zero, so gain A approaches infinity. So when the gain approaches infinity, the system can go into oscillation. So it can also work as an oscillator. Okay. Now we will see another characteristic of tunnel diode, that is a tunnel diode as a negative resistance amplifier. That is, here we have connected our tunnel diode along with the circulator. So we all are now familiar with the working of circulator. How will the signal flow in circulator? In a circular fashion, say here we are providing the input from port 1, so it goes to port 2, and from port 2 we connect the tunnel diode. And so the amplified signal now comes at port 3, and the amplified output, we are connecting it through the port 3, we are connecting it to a load. Okay, so signal can flow here only in a circular fashion from nth port to n plus 1th port. So that is why in the second port we connect our tunnel diode and the third port we connect a load. So finally the amplified output is got from port 3. Okay, now in this case, if I am considering, say there will be obviously impedance mismatches since we are connecting our hybrid component circulator to the tunnel diode. So how can I write the expression for the reflection coefficient? We know that the reflection coefficient in general, it is given by the expression ZL minus ZO by ZL plus ZO, as learned from the previous semesters. Now here the characteristic impedance ZO, I can represent here as say R0. I have considered instead of Z, I have represented it by the letter R itself. So the characteristic impedance for the circulator is considered perfect and positive real, and have represented to be R0, capital R0. So that is this particular second term, that is ZO is now represented by capital R0. And what is the load impedance ZL here? Since we are connecting the tunnel diode as a load, and we know the magnitude of negative resistance of the tunnel diode as minus RN, instead of ZL, we have replaced here with minus RN. Okay, so here how the expression of the reflection coefficient comes, tau is equal to minus of RN minus RO divided by minus of RN plus RO. Okay, so here what we have to consider here is that if this particular term in the denominator, that is the RN minus of RN, okay, if it is becoming minus of RO, okay, so minus of RO and plus of RO, it is going to become zero. So we get 1 by 0, an infinity value for our reflection coefficient. Okay. So if we are designing in such a manner, that is what is written here. By selecting a negative resistance tunnel diode whose input impedance has a real part equal to minus of R naught and an imaginary part equal to 0. Okay. So if this particular term turns out to be minus of RO, so minus of RO plus RO, we get what? An infinite value for our reflection coefficient. Now, if the value of the reflection coefficient is infinite, our gain is also going to be infinite, since the expression connecting between the gain and the reflection coefficient is such a way that gain is a square of reflection coefficient. Okay, gain is proportional to the square of reflection coefficient. So if the reflection coefficient is infinite, gain is also going to be infinite. So an amplifier with infinite gain can be built. It is possible to build an infinite gain amplifier if you are connecting a tunnel diode along with the circulator. That is what is explained in this point. And always remember, we consider the working of tunnel diode amplifier and the tunnel diode microwave oscillator only in the negative resistance region. Now, a tunnel diode can also be used as an oscillator when connected in series with a tank circuit. So here LC here represents our tank circuit. So a tunnel diode is always operated in the negative resistance region. When operated in the negative resistance region, the tunnel diode works very well as an oscillator. So in the IV characteristics of tunnel diode, the negative resistance region is a region between the peak current, that is IP, and the valley current, that is IV. So if you are biasing your diode somewhere in between or a middle of this region, the tunnel diode can very well give oscillations. So if a tunnel diode is placed, say, in series with a tank circuit and biased at the center of the negative resistance portion of the characteristic, here marked as a dot, and undamped oscillations are produced at the output. It is because the negative resistance characteristics of the tunnel diode counteracts the positive resistance characteristic of a tank circuit. So here the resistance R1 is used for proper biasing of the tunnel diode. That is, it should bias in such a way that the tunnel diode is working in the negative resistance region, and R2 is for biasing of the LC circuit, that is a tank circuit here, for proper biasing of the tank circuit. So what happens here, when the device starts working and when you are providing the voltage, the tunnel diodes will be set into oscillations and the frequency of the oscillation will be corresponding to the frequencies of the tank circuit. Okay. Now for the parallel circuit, that is a parallel tank circuit which consists of L and C, and also considering the internal resistance A of RP, it is connected across the tunnel diode. We know the magnitude of negative resistance of tunnel diode represented as minus of Rn. So if you are considering the equivalent resistance, that is both of them in parallel, RP and minus of Rn in parallel, it is given by the expression. So from the expression, if RP is greater than Rn, our equivalent resistance will be negative and the oscillations can build up. The oscillation amplitude will grow until it occupies a voltage greater than the extent of negative resistance region of the characteristics. When the operating point enter the region of positive resistance, then the amplitude of oscillation is limited. That is, as much as a tunnel diode is operating in the negative resistance region, we get sustained oscillation. Once it enters or leave the value of the region of the negative resistance region and it goes to the positive resistance region, you see that the oscillations will be damped or it will get limited and then finally stop. Okay, so a tunnel diode has a characteristic with a negative resistance region between a voltage of approximately 0.1 and 0.3 volt, and in that range it can be used as an oscillator giving oscillating frequencies up to 100 gigahertz. Okay, so understand about the basic construction of tunnel diode, the conditions for tunneling, and with the help of energy band diagram, learn how to explain the working of the tunnel diode step by step, explain the tunneling process, and then understand certain characteristics of tunnel diode. So a problem for the tunnel diode is shown here. So certain parameters of the tunnel diode is shown, okay, and it is telling to calculate the resistive cutoff frequency and self-resonant frequency of the diode. So we have already seen about the equivalent circuit of tunnel diode, and we have written the expression for input impedance of that equivalent circuit, and from it we have written the expression for resistive cutoff frequency and self-resonating frequency. So since we are having all these parameters, we could directly substitute in that particular equation and get the answer. So this is one of the problem which could be asked from the section of microwave tunnel diode.